Welcome to our lecture online. Here we have a couple more examples of how to simplify expressions. Starting with one on the right, notice we have a division and we have an exponent. The rules tell us exponents go first, so let's go ahead and take care of this first. So this becomes equal to 35 divided by 12 divided by, and now we apply the exponent, this becomes 25 over, not 4, but 4 squared, which is 16. All right, now we can go ahead and take care of that division. The rule tells us that if we divide with a fraction, it's the same as multiplying by its inverse. So this can now be written as 35 over 12 multiplied times the inverse of that, which is 16 over 25. Now we can go ahead and simplify things. Notice we have a 35 and a 25. They're both divisible by 5. So 25 divided by 5 is 5. 35 divided by 5 is 7. And then you see that we have 12 and 16. They're both divisible by 4, so 12 divided by 4 is 3. 16 divided by 4 is 4. And now we can go ahead and complete this. 7 times 4 gives us 28 in the numerator, and 3 times 5 gives us 15 in the denominator. And that's the final simplified form of that expression. Now we take a look at the second one right here. We need to be very careful. We might be tempted by thinking this is 3 halves divided by this quantity right here. And we might want to start on the right side rather than on the left side. That's dangerous to try to do that. Not that you'll get hurt if you do it, but you might not get the right result. And so always strictly follow the rules, start from left and work your way to the right. So we're going to take care of this portion here first. And again, the rule is that if we divide with a fraction, it's the same as multiplying by its inverse. So this can now be written as 3 over 2 multiplied times a negative 4 over 21 divided by, we'll leave this one alone, minus 12 divided by 7. So we're going to take care of this product first before we deal with that division symbol. Before we multiply, notice we can do some simplification here. The 3 and the 21 are both divisible by 3, so 3 divided by 3 is 1, 21 divided by 3 is 7. And notice the 2 and the 4 are both divisible by 2, so 2 divided by 2 is 1, 4 divided by 2 is 2. And now we can simplify that. So we have 1 times a negative 2 is a negative 2, divided by 1 times 7 is 7. So we have a negative 2 over 7, and that is now divided by negative 12 over 7. Now we can go ahead and take care of this right here. Notice when we divide by fraction, it's the same as multiply by inverse, so this can be written as negative 2 over 7 times negative 7 over 12. Notice we have a multiplication. Both numbers are negative, and negative times a negative gives us a positive. But before we multiply, let's see if we can simplify some things. 7 divided by 7 is 1, and 2 and 12 are both divisible by 2, so 2 divided by 2 is 1, and 12 divided by 2 is 6. And again, the negative cancels out the negative, and this leaves us with a 1 times 1 divided by 1 times 6, and that's the final reduced form of that expression. That's how it's done.